So I'm back. Obviously, I took a week off for Thanksgiving, and during that time, unfortunately, there were some issues that I missed that I definitely want to talk about. I know there's new news every day to talk about, but some important things happened that I simply cannot ignore. And one of those important things happens to be an interview that Fox News host Brian Kilmeade did with conservative talker Charlie Kirk. And in this interview with Charlie Kirk, Brian Kilmeade, while promoting a new book he, you know, allegedly wrote, actually defended slave owners. Not defended slavery, of course, you know, because that would just be a bridge too far, but he defended the people who owned other human beings as property. Here is what Mr. Kilmeade had to say to Charlie Kirk. Quote, for the most part, we're a country that was born, like every other country, every continent had slaves. In the South, most houses, most plantations had slaves. Nobody condones it. But without those slave owners, we don't have a country, so you make your choice. What do you mean, so you make your choice? Like, the choices were already made hundreds of years ago. Like, what are you telling us to make a choice about right now? That doesn't even make any sense grammatically or intelligently. Like, you make your choice, right? You want to have slave owners or not? No, we don't. But none of us were alive back then to be able to say that. So I don't know what choice you want us to make. But I think Kilmeade immediately realized how stupid his comment was, because then he tried to not necessarily walk it back, because he still wanted to defend the slave owners. But then he tried to soften it by saying this. Because of the 1619 Project was the formal first salvo. Look, I mean, I'm older than you. And in 1976, I was in grade school. And they launched this thing called Roots, the most successful miniseries ever. Averaged 60 million a night. It was the story of slavery and all its brutality. Nobody was ever ducking our past. I don't know what people were talking about. And no one ever said, oh, segregation, not that bad. Slavery, well, it happens. So he's trying to say, like, hey, listen, you know, back in the day, we didn't run from our history. It was on Roots. And, you know, nobody was defending segregation or slavery. So, you know, it was bad. But didn't you just kind of defend it? Because you said, I mean, you did say, without it, we wouldn't have a country. But then you're saying, but back in the day, we were taught to not defend it. And then in modern times, here you are quite literally defending it. So you learn nothing is the moral of this story. You tried to soften your statement by saying, hey, listen, I wasn't taught to defend slavery. Yet here I am, almost 50 years later, totally defending slave owners and by extension slavery, by telling you that there would not be a country had it not been for slave owners. This is like a total mask-off moment for Brian Kilmeade, literally admitting that he was raised and everybody in that time was taught how bad this was, and they were taught, do not defend this. But over the decades, I guess those lessons were forgotten, weren't they, Brian? Or maybe not forgotten, but you realized how profitable it can be on the right to go out there and defend these things. There is no defense of slavery. There is no defense of slave owners. Oh, it was a different time. Every country had this, as Brian Kilmeade said. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. It doesn't make it okay. And also, for the record, I don't know that you understood what you were also saying, because you're also pointing out a very important fact by admitting that without the hard work, forced labor, really, of those slaves, we wouldn't have a country. And yet you still treat you, your network, you know, you treat people coming into this country as if they're beneath you, while at the same time admitting that we wouldn't even have a country without them. So maybe you ought to reflect on your own words here, Brian, because you're admitting a lot about who you are, how you were raised, and how you still managed to become a total piece of crap in the end. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.